Thank you very much. I'm delighted to be in Liverpool. I'm also delighted to talk about my book, The Ghost of Sani Abacha. It seems to me that as soon as I chose this title, something began to happen in the heavenlies. It was as if the ghost started to haunt everything. And as soon as I said, I'm going to launch the book on the 9th in Asaba, all of a sudden, things began to happen. And the 1st of January, the fuel price more than doubled in Nigeria. And the 9th of January, which was the same day this book was to be launched in Asaba, the national, Labour Congress declared a general strike. So it was as if the ghost was now haunting the country. But these really are tales of life and love that are set in the aftermath of a military dictatorship. The idea is that none of these stories are actually written in a politically dangerous era. The dictators are dead and buried. We're supposed to be all, you know, everything's supposed to be going on. But we notice that there is something slightly different about the characters, about the men, the women. They all have tasted life in a dictatorship, and some of them have been marked, maybe not too nicely, by the experience. It's like an incubus gets up, but what's the effect on the victim? Aha, let's look at a story called High Fidelity. I want a divorce, I'll tell her. She will not understand. She will sit there on the sofa where the shock has dropped her. She will breathe in quickly, waiting for the rumble of my laughter, which would have signaled that I was only joking after all. It will not come. Then the pinpricks of sweat will appear on the tip of her nose as she cross-examines me closely. Is it a loan to Safia that I didn't tell you about? It is not, I'll tell her. Dairy. So it's that old quarrel. It is not, I'll tell her. That quarrel about me laughing about you. It's not about any quarrel, Magia. And it's not about the children that we don't have, that I've told you for years and years that I'm not bothered about. And it's not about that 19-year-old secretary either. So what is it about then? Why do you want to do this to us? And at that, I will look at her and fall silent. Because it is difficult to explain that you are divorcing your wife over a pot of soup and how she looked at armed robbers in a way she used to look at soldiers in uniform, in a way she had never looked at you. I think in this book there are 26 stories there, but there are probably 4 or 5 totally political stories. And even then they are character driven. They're never really, you know, they're all stories set in the politics of post-dictatorship. And obviously you would feel the, you know, the things that are wrong with it. But you basically are following the characters, the good characters, their noble intentions, their purposes. Bullfight, for instance, is the story of a young man who has never done anything with his life. He's just basically a coward, just lying up, you know, hanging on a tree. He was called Tree Man. But eventually the trees in his village are threatened with, you know, we're going to cut them all down. And he sees for the first time in his life a cause that he feels totally about. And he goes about, you know, raising awareness in the village, collecting a petition, signatures for a petition. Everybody signs up because they see him, this is the first thing he's really done. And so so that story is powered by his, and you know, his fate and whatever happens to him. And I think for me it's important that I do a lot of activist writing, and it's important to make a clear distinction between when I set up to write to tell you, please do this, and when I'm writing to entertain. And I want you, if you read a story, you're reading it, you don't feel at any point anybody has an agenda. You're just basically reading about somebody. So you're reading it purely for entertainment. Maybe when you have fallen asleep, you might wake up and think, hey, you know, there's something there, that's okay. But it would be, for me, it would be wrong for a creative writer to, you know, begin to set out an agenda in his writing.